autonomous vehicle, cars without wheels, without steering wheels, without pedals, without drivers, cars that can drive at 100 miles an hour on the autobahn in all weather conditions, fog, smog, heavy snow, and so forth. Does it exist today? No. Will it exist tomorrow? No. Will it ever exist? No, unless you solve the radar problem. So hopefully in my presentation, I will address the two issues that Tim Higgins, you know, I mentioned this morning from Wall Street: vision and speed. So MetaWave was incorporated less than a year ago. We raised $7 million in seed round. The technology was licensed from Xerox PARC. This is the innovation hub of Xerox. As you know, they enabled big corporations to succeed in Silicon Valley. One of them is Steve Jobs, Apple Corporation. We go after two markets. Why? Because the solution that we have in hand also addresses a major issue that is in the heart of the 5G wireless network. But our primary focus is the automotive market. So our Warlord sensor will address the long range, all weather condition, AI at the analog and edge processing. That's something that you cannot replace with just the software and back end AI. Why? Because our human brain, our sensing are all analog. So you have to create what we call a smart material that will be able to detect, track, and classify objects at the long range. Second product is the Saber product. We will also be at Mobile World Congress, where we'll be addressing the multi-user 4G LTE and the 5G. And the irony in all of this, a very simple, innovative technology solves two fundamental problems in two large industries that are converging very soon. So we're very thrilled to have such an opportunity and to be able to make such a dent in history. So what is the missing sensor today? This morning, the media panel spoke a lot about LiDAR and cameras. No one mentioned the word radar until someone asked the question, so are there any companies flying under the radar? And the reason is because such technology doesn't exist today, not in the tier ones, not in their pipelines. And the reason is because everybody relies on digital signal processing, manipulating zeros and ones. You lose a lot of information once you go to zeros and ones. This is why our brain doesn't do that. So we try now to push that complexity to the analog space using a very simple smart material. As you can see in my pocket, it's only two layers of copper and substrate. No exotic material, but the algorithm resides in the heart of our AI engine. So a sensor that can see long ranges, 3D vision, with embedded AI engine that operate at the analog and digital space and operate at a microsecond speed, not millisecond speed. Why the Waymos today are not driving at 70 miles an hour? Because they do all the signal processing in the digital space. They are at a millisecond. We also want to bring it down to nanosecond in the future if possible. And ultimately, of course, the V2X, bringing also, merging these two industries together. So in my next videos, Ben, if you can play the videos, I will show you our vision that we will display at CES in January. So as you can see, in the heart of the Warlord is that little piece I just showed you. As the car starts moving, it has a white beam to basically screen the world around it. Then it detects these objects. As it detects it up with this pencil beam, it raster around them, and the AI engine will tell them, yes, this is a road sign, this is a pedestrian, this is a car, and so forth. It does this at a 300-meter range in all weather conditions at microsecond speed, something you cannot do today or tomorrow with conventional radar, with LiDAR, or cameras. So I'm very thrilled to have the opportunity to lead such a venture when the PARC CEO asked me to basically start MetaWave. My background, I've been working for 25 years in the wireless industry. I have a PhD in physics, so I understand the RF and analog space very quite well. But also I worked in a lot of defense projects that basically address a lot of these problems. But cost was an issue there. We cannot bring these high costs into the commercial market. So what is Warlord? Nobody believed when we told them in 5 months we will demonstrate the Warlord sensor at CES, and in 7 months we will demonstrate our Saber at Mobile World Congress. Because I have a very strong core team, over 20 patents have been filed by MetaWave in the meantime. So 300 meter, 1 degree beam, being able to be steered horizontal and vertical at microsecond and hopefully in nanosecond speed, and also the AI engine in the background. Without building our own ASIC, we rely on the tier 2s, Infineon, NXP, and TI. And we're working with a broad range of companies, from the manufacturing partners to the tier 2s to the OEMs. We see ourselves as a bridge between the tier 2s and the tier 1s and the OEM, helping them all to solve this problem today. And on the 5G, it's very simple. We work with three companies, Huawei, Ericsson, and Nokia, to help them roll out their 5G network while working with Docomo, SoftBank, Verizon, and AT&T to also enable them to bring the cost down to the consumer and to the cars of the future. Thank you.
You win. You get some questions. So did anyone actually understand enough to ask a question of Maha? If not, you can ask maybe a business type of question. Gary?
Why need a microphone?
Here.
I'm losing my voice.
Okay.
Oh, I have a microphone.
Oh, you're lucky.
God said that. Why is that radar different than existing radar? What have you done? And explain the algorithms that you've also built on the back end.
So if you see that smart skin, it has over 150 little cells. It's like our little cells here. And each cell has an active component that is able to steer the beam and form the beam in all these directions and at these speeds, all done at analog. Today's radar, and as a matter of fact, also in communication, they have to take multiple antennas, digitize every single stream, do all the processing in the back end. So think about scalability, cost of the silicon. When you have 32 ports, we only use one port. And this is why the tier 2s are very excited. We shrunk the size of their ASIC because we only need one port to their ASIC while enabling and delivering such a performance.
And are you doing your own AI?
Absolutely. Yes.
On the optical benefit.
But having said that, there are many companies that are asking just for raw data. We will give them the raw data. I don't want to monopolize the market. But I will also offer the AI post-processing in case it's needed. Thank you.
Is that so? Yep. Can you make it quick?
AI on the object recognition.
Yes.
How comparable is a camera? I know you got probably before the ring.
Than a camera does, but is the database for object recognition similar in the development?
It's similar to LiDAR. Let's put it this way. So it's you can train the engine to recognize these objects, but unlike cameras and LiDAR, you can do it at 300 meters.
Okay.
And like cameras and LiDAR, you can do it in all weather conditions with glare and everything. So the car will not stop on the side when it's in the
sun. I'm gonna stop you there.
Okay.
But you can talk to me afterwards.
We do have a 10-minute break when we're done, and I'm sure.